So I see it as dangerous that the white supremacists are getting as visually clever as the left wing was and still is.
That's a piece from Newsweek breaking down how white supremacists are using strategies of the left, supposedly, to spread their message of hate. And now the group Identify Europa is launching a year-long campaign to target college students with sophisticated racist flyers. The Anti-Defamation League reports the group has posted flyers on 13 campuses in 7 states since this school year began. And since September of last year, the ADL found white supremacists posted flyers on 131 college campuses in 37 states. Those hate flyers appear at the University of Virginia just weeks before the violence in Charlottesville. That's where counter-protesters clashed with white supremacists over the removal of a Robert E. Lee statue. One person died, Heather Heyer, and more than a dozen others were injured. All right, to our panel, let's talk about this idea of recruiting these college campuses. I was talking to a media executive about this, and this person told me, he said, I was shocked to see in Charlottesville these young white college students, and this was a white male, and I went, where you been?
For real.
I said, that's the recruiting ground, because they believe that somehow that things have just changed and it's so rough for them,
right,
being young white men in America.
Yeah, I mean, and I don't agree that they have been, following the lead of what the left has done. They've actually been following the lead of what the right has done previously, particularly if you look at anti-choice organizations. They've been targeting college campuses for years, and they've been very effective in spreading their message around the sort of the younger generation. And what you see here are these white ring racists doing the very same thing. Mm-hmm. People like to believe that millennials are somehow less racist than their grandparents. The reality is, if you look at survey data around this, overall it will look like millennials are less racist, but when you disaggregate that by race, you will see that what's going on is that there are more millennials of color, and that's what moves the numbers over. Mm-hmm. When you look specifically at white millennials, they're just as racist as their parents are. We are not moving the needle in terms of that. And in fact, with what's going on under this culture with this administration in office, it's actually getting worse.
Well, Lena, as you know, I served as president for the United States Student Association for 2 years. I was president of my all-white university, University of California, Santa Cruz, and during my campaign election, a noose was hung on my door. So I have not been hiding under a rock. This has been an issue for a very, very, very long time. Anybody who is surprised by this at this point, I don't even want to talk and deal with them because they have no solutions. But if we're going to talk about how we end this work, like you said, this is a breeding ground, and campuses across this country,
right,
especially higher education, have always been vehicles for civic engagement and education and recruitment. Mm-hmm. So this is problematic because the most vulnerable spaces, you can hang a noose or do put graffiti on a wall somewhere where workers are, because workers have things to do, they have kids and they have to go home at night. But campuses and students take risk, and they are on their campuses and they will fight and push back,
George,
and that is dangerous.
Let me say that we are totally, as Black Pack and as myself, we denounce racism in any form. I actually do not agree with the state of Virginia. They should have charged this guy who ran his car into these people with murder, one. One, because the airbag did not go off, so it was either disconnected or Chrysler made a defective product. I challenged the prosecutor in Virginia to raise those charges and go after a charge that will watch this guy hang or get the death penalty. That's the first thing I want to make. I want to make that point because I don't think Virginia's being hard enough on this. Number two, this car should not have been able to back up. When the airbag goes off, that steering wheel should lock and the gear should
Hold on.
So I want to make that point.
I got that point.
You got that point.
We're talking about the recruiting on college campuses.
I'm not deflecting. The recruiting on college campuses is a serious issue. Yeah. It's something that we have to engage with and let these people know they've got great opportunities. Black people have great opportunity. Asians have great opportunity. We want to represent everybody. I have a lot of white friends.
We know white folks got a lot of great opportunities.
We know they do. But we have a great opportunity, too, to go and engage this in a peaceful manner. We don't have to be violent. We don't have to meet violence with violence. Mm-hmm. We can take the step of Martin Luther King.
Where are we going?
First of all,
this is not two sides.
No, the other
you're
side
doing the two
is
sides.
Well, what's the other side?
The Antifa side, or whatever you want to call it, the Nazi side. These people are coming prepared to do violence. So we have to make sure that we're aware of when they're stepping up and how we fight them.
This is very simple.
This is very
simple. Jim Crow had children and grandchildren. That's what we are seeing.
I'm not going to say every white person is racist.
I'm sorry. Did you hear me say that?
No.
You won't deny
no.
the white supremacy, though.
I will deny
the white supremacy. Stop. So if you didn't hear me say that, why would you then come?
That's, I just
then,
make that
then,
clear.
That's your response. But hell, it's clear because
I defend white people.
I don't have to make something clear that was unclear. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is that Jim Crow had children and grandchildren. Mm-hmm. And when you say that you have folks, the Richard Spencers of the world, and folks like him, they have this belief that somehow, that, like, we are operating in what I call white minority resistance.
Yes.
Where there's this belief that, oh my God, we're losing our power, as if, okay, that building back there isn't nearly all white. The people who work there are nearly all white. That's just a reality. And so they're living in a fantasy land that's made up, because if you study American history, where there's ever been any black progress, there's been white backlash.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. In American history, since August of 1619, we've always seen that. And that's what we're seeing right now. Mm-hmm. And so my deal is, you got to target this, because those are the folks, again, who are going to be bosses tomorrow. And they're gonna carry those same attitudes in the workplace.
Weekdays on TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't wanna talk to us, he wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no! That ain't gonna cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin, weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.